Here is NUCIDA's weekly forecast about the expected post activities in the realms of software quality in the social media channels in week 22 of 2025. Our analysis is based on the social post data of LinkedIn, YouTube, X, and other internet sources released last week and detected dynamic daily changes. I'll leverage the provided web results, which cover software quality trends for 2025, and combine them with logical extrapolation of ongoing conversations in the tech community. The ranking is based on the prominence of topics in recent publications, their relevance to current software quality challenges, and their engagement potential on the mentioned platforms. Each topic's ranking reflects its immediacy, impact, and discussion volume, with reasons for placement and a forecast for future trends included. So, what will be the top 10 hot topics this week? Buckle up and let's start the countdown. 10. Shift left testing. Shift left testing, integrating testing early in the software development lifecycle, SDLC, continues to gain traction on social media and blogs. It's discussed for reducing defect costs by catching issues during the requirements or design phases. It ranks at 10 as an established practice, with steady but less explosive chatter compared to newer trends. My advice? AI-driven test case generation will enhance shift-left testing, predicting defects during code commits, and integrating seamlessly into CI/CD pipelines. Adopt shift-left by embedding QA engineers in sprint planning and using automated tools like TestRail to create test cases during requirements gathering. Train developers in basic testing practices to foster a quality-first mindset from the start. 9. Test data management, TDM. TDM is critical for generating realistic, secure, and compliant test data, especially for complex applications. Social media discussions focus on GDPR compliance and synthetic data tools, while blogs highlight solutions like Delphix or Scase for data masking and data transformation. It ranks at 9 due to its niche but essential role in testing accuracy. My advice? AI-generated synthetic data will dominate TDM, mimicking real-world scenarios for AI/ML testing while adhering to stricter privacy regulations. Invest in TDM tools like Delphix or Redgate for secure data generation. Implement data masking and synthetic data pipelines to ensure compliance and reduce the risks of data breaches during testing. 8. Performance testing for cloud-native applications. Performance testing for cloud-native apps, e.g., microservices, serverless, is trending due to the need for scalability and low latency. Social media conversations mention tools like JMeter and Gatling, while blogs on DZone focus on Kubernetes testing. It ranks at 8 as it's specific to cloud environments, which are widespread but not universal. My advice? Chaos engineering will integrate with performance testing, with tools like Chaos Monkey, simulating failures to ensure quality in cloud environments. Use tools like Gatling, Locust, NeoLoad, or LoadRunner for load testing, and integrate chaos engineering with Chaos Monkey to simulate real-world failures. Monitor cloud-specific metrics, e.g., container latency, to optimize performance testing. 7. Accessibility testing. Accessibility testing is surging due to regulatory demands, e.g., ADA, WCAG, and user expectations for inclusive software. Social media posts share tools like Axe and Wave, while blogs on Smashing Magazine discuss integrating accessibility into QA, it ranks at 7 as a growing but not yet dominant topic. My advice? AI tools will automate WCAG violation fixes, driven by stricter global accessibility regulations. Incorporate automated tools like Axe into CI/CD pipelines to catch accessibility issues early. Train QA teams on WCAG 2.2 guidelines and conduct manual testing with screen readers to ensure inclusive user experiences. 6. Security testing integration. With cybercrime costs projected at $10 trillion in 2025, security testing is critical. Social media discussions focus on DevSecOps tools like Snyke and OWASP Zap in CI/CD pipelines, while blogs on Security Boulevard emphasize secure coding. It ranks at 6 due to its overlap with cybersecurity, but strong QA relevance. My advice? AI-driven predictive threat detection will enhance security testing analyzing code for vulnerabilities pre-deployment. Embed security testing in CI/CD using tools like Snyk for code scanning and OWASP Zap for API testing. Adopt a zero trust approach and train developers on secure coding practices to minimize vulnerabilities. 5. Low-code, no-code testing challenges. The $65 billion low-code, no-code market drives discussions on testing apps built by non-technical users. Social media posts highlight challenges with platforms like OutSystems, while blogs on TechBeacon discuss automated testing for citizen developers. It ranks at 5 due to its growing relevance. My advice: specialized testing frameworks and test factory platform solutions for low-code platforms will emerge, with AI automating test creation for non-coders. Use visual testing tools like AppleTools and AI-powered testing frameworks and platforms like BrainTestwork to validate low-code app UIs. Collaborate with citizen developers to define testable requirements and leverage automation tools tailored for low-code platforms like OutSystems. 4. Continuous testing in DevOps. Continuous testing is central to DevOps, with social media buzz around tools like Jenkins and CircleCI for CI/CD integration. Blogs on DevOps.com stress real-time feedback for rapid releases. It ranks at 4 due to its widespread adoption and frequent mentions. My advice: continuous testing will integrate with observability tools for real-time production quality insights. Implement continuous testing with tools like CircleCI and Selenium for automated regression tests. Define clear KPIs, e.g., 90% test coverage, and integrate testing into every CI/CD stage to ensure rapid, high-quality releases. 3. AI-driven test automation. AI-driven test automation is transformative, with 80% of teams expected to adopt AI tools by 2025. Social media discussions highlight self-healing scripts with Testem and Mabel, while blogs on InfoQ note reduce test maintenance. It ranks at 3 for its impact and engagement. My advice: generative AI will create dynamic test cases, minimizing human intervention in regression testing. Adopt AI-driven tools like Testem or Functionize for self-healing tests. Start with small-scale pilots to identify high-maintenance test suites and use AI analytics to prioritize risk-based test cases. 2. Quality engineering for AI/ML systems. Testing AI/ML systems is a top concern due to their non-deterministic nature. Social media posts discuss challenges in validating ML models, while blogs on Towards Data Science explore MLOps pipelines. It ranks at 2 for its complexity and urgency in ensuring reliable AI. My advice: QA frameworks like TensorFlow Extended, TFX, will focus on model fairness, robustness, and drift detection. Use MLOps tools like TFX or MLflow to test AI model performance and fairness. Implement data drift monitoring and validate models against diverse datasets to ensure robustness and ethical outcomes. 1. Observability-driven quality assurance. Observability, combining monitoring, logging, and tracing, leads discussions for its proactive approach to quality. Social media is abuzz with tools like Datadog and Grafana, while blogs on New Relic emphasize real-time defect detection. It ranks at 1 for its cutting-edge impact and high visibility. My advice: observability will leverage AI for predictive defect analysis, with automated root cause tools dominating QA. Integrate observability tools like Grafana or New Relic into production environments to monitor real-time quality metrics. Set up alerts for anomalies, e.g., latency spikes, and use tracing to pinpoint defects quickly. Forecast for upcoming topics for the next months in 2025. 1. Quantum computing testing. Testing quantum algorithms will emerge as quantum computing advances, with blogs discussing tools like IBM's Qiskit. My advice: stay informed on quantum testing frameworks like Qiskit and start experimenting with quantum simulators to prepare for future QA needs. 2. Sustainability in software. Quality, eco-friendly coding practices will influence QA, optimizing software for lower energy use. My advice: measure software energy consumption using tools like GreenFrame and prioritize lightweight code in QA processes to support sustainability goals. 3. synthetic user testing with digital twins. Digital twins will simulate user interactions for IoT and edge computing testing. My advice? Explore digital twin platforms like AWS IoT TwinMaker for realistic user scenario testing, ensuring robust QA for distributed systems. Hopefully this video gives you additional insights. What do you think about the hot topics this week? Write your views in the comments section below. In terms of further questions, feel free to write to us. We will analyze all important internet channels and release our analysis report every Monday. Follow or subscribe to this channel to stay up to date and know more than your competitors. Happy testing, and see you next time.